It's finally here! Our first look at not just Moana, but at her movie. This is such a big deal that I dropped everything else that I was doing to cover these photos. Because not only do we finally get to see them, but we've actually been given a pretty good look at the film for an introduction, and they're spectacular. So let's dive right in. First off, as you can see, we have Moana here, fully rendered. But I have to say, while that's the full color version of her as she's going to appear in the film, what I really like, which really makes me like the character, is the study of her different expressions beside her. Particularly that one where there's just such a look of joy on her face, and you can see the wind in her hair. She just really looks spectacular there. I hope that that will be translated into the CGI version, because we've seen this a couple of times now, where you'll see the character study that's drawn, it's hand drawn, and it has a lot more life and, you know, personality in it, and is more reminiscent of what we've come to expect from Disney animation than the CGI model, right? You know, there's so many times where just a little part of you is like, oh, I wish you'd hand drawn this. I think that was particularly the case with Tangled, whereas, of course, you can't fault Frozen in any regard because it was just such an astounding success. But I do prefer the hand-drawn version of the character slightly to the CGI model, but that's just because the CGI model is giving us so much sass, and I'm pretty used to, you know, female heroines giving us a lot of sass. I think it's a little bit old now. But the character, I love her costume, her outfit, very authentic. You're going to see that authenticity is a major concern for Disney with this movie, as it should be. However, from a marketing brand perspective, you have to wonder if that authenticity is going to hurt Moana when it comes to being part of the Disney Princess brand. Because so far, as we've seen, if you don't got a gown and you don't got a crown, you just don't play with the Disney Princess crowd. It's been very difficult for Pocahontas and Mulan because of that. Jasmine has escaped it. She's got billowy pants that are kind of like a gown. And that's the whole reason Tiana was created. And I think that she Jasmine have had the most success in diversifying, but while still remaining somewhat true to their cultures, because, you know, Tiana represents New Orleans in the Jazz Age, and I think she does a very good job with that indeed. So, you know, you want to stay true to the culture and the heritage that you're depicting, but you also need to appeal to the Disney Princess fan base, which is incredibly powerful. So while I love Moana, and I can see people wanting to dress in this costume, etc., I do wonder if it's going to work in the way it needs to in being a part of the Disney Princess brand. Or maybe it'll become its own brand, almost as Frozen has, and then it won't be an issue. That would be great. That would be ideal, obviously. I also think we have to point out that this is a very different build for a Disney princess. This is an athletic build. It's a very realistic build. It's something we haven't really seen before with any of the characters. I think the closest we've seen to this, where it was slightly exaggerated, was Lilo and Stitch. You know, Chris Sanders made quite an effort to make those characters very realistic in terms of body proportions. And I would even say he went beyond realistic. Because it was a very stylized movie. But this is trying to go for realism, although because she looks doll-like, because she's a CGI character, she reminds me actually a little bit slightly of American Girl dolls, and those are a very popular brand as well. So we'll see. But I'm curious, what do you think of Moana now that you finally get to see her? Do you appreciate her authenticity? And do you think she's going to succeed not just as a Disney animated character, but as a Disney animated princess? Oh, and do you prefer the CGI version or the pencil version? All right, next up we have a great picture of her talking, you know, having her hair braided, and I'm sure conversing with this older woman. Either they're related or it's a member of her tribe. Although that necklace looks like the one she's wearing in some of the images, the hand-drawn one. So it's another just like Pocahontas, you know, getting an important necklace that she decides to wear. But it's a very nice image. I like that as well. You can just see this tying in to the very strong investment that Disney has made into Polynesia, be it the Disney's Polynesian Resort in Orlando, to the Disneyland Hotel, Trader Sam's Tiki Bar, to, of course, the Aulani Resort in Hawaii itself. So that's very nice. But then we're going to go here to, this is another, obviously, hand-drawn version of a character. We don't have a CGI model for him, but this is the Rock's character, Maui, and the Rock said he loves his tattoos, which apparently I'm hearing can come to life. So that's great. He looks very cool. very personality driven. He seems a little bit exaggerated in his proportions, but he looks like a really cool character. Again, I think they really seem to be striving for authenticity and authentic, even with that giant hook, because, you know, he's been raised by the gods and Maui. Maui's a little bit special, as I'm sure we're going to find out. Although I'm sure The Rock would attest that he could lift something of that size anyway in real life. Then next up, you see Moana's father, Tui. I think he looks very nice as well. He has the tribal tattoos. I wonder if Moana will get tattoos. For those of you who are more familiar with Polynesian culture, are tattoos with women as big as they are with men in that culture. But he looks very cool. He looks very nice. He's also sporting some pretty darn nice jewelry. And I think he looks pretty on model with the hand-drawn character study and the CGI version. All right, so those are our human characters. Now we're going to move on to some inhuman characters. And this is one of my favorite images, this lava witch. That's really awesome. I don't know if that's a man or a woman, actually. I assumed it was a woman, but I could be wrong. But just the way the character looks there, not only do I appreciate just the styling, but I really appreciate the movie taking the extra, you know, cranking it up to an 11, right? I mean, they didn't have to go that awesome and go that far. And I think that kind of character model really seems to lend itself, I think, to the what you can do with CGI animation, computer animation. There's Moana there, cowering more than one would suspect considering all the sass she was throwing out in that first photo, but we'll see what happens here in the story. But that's far more spectacular than I had been anticipating. Next, you have a great little picture of what I'm assuming is Moana's village. It's nestled in there. It looks like a cross between Neverland and also the Aulani Resort in Hawaii, which I'm sure they would love for you to equate the two and say, I love Moana so much, I'm going to go visit the Disney Resort in Hawaii. And they'll have a vacation package, I'm sure, ready for you. I love the color. Very vibrant. Really spectacular. I want to go there right now. Then here's another great image of apparently the ocean having like a personality. And I believe that's supposed to be a younger version of Moana. I like the tomboy aspects to her there. This, of course, also hand-drawn. You see a little bit what, you know, like the hand-drawn can do in terms of stylization. When you have a film that's, 2D animated, you can go a little more stylized. Sleeping Beauty is a great example of that. And here you see some stylization as well. But when you go to computer animation, I think one of the things that has been lost there, because they can mimic reality so well, is they've lost some of that stylization, which I feel is a little unfortunate. But at least they're pushing the bar in terms of design, like with that lava witch. But the ocean here, they say they're working very hard to animate it and create it as a character all by itself, but apparently that means with a personality that can play Tootsie with you. So that's very pretty as well. I'm sure everybody loves to put their toes in the water. Who wouldn't love for it to play back in a nice way? And then here's another great image of it looks like young Moana as a child, you know, I probably at first falling in love with the sea. I think that looks really great. She has some kind of like chieftain headdress on. Maybe she borrowed it from her father. But I think that's wonderful. I think it's really important. Every Disney princess has had something that she likes, especially as of late. But I think that's important that Moana not just like the sea, but I think that her wanting to be an explorer is really important, you know, or an adventurer. And that would be really wonderful. I think that you see that in some regard in all Disney heroines, but for her to want to be someone who charts the stars and goes out into the ocean, I think is pretty exemplary. Although Milo from Atlantis was into that, and that didn't do him any favors whatsoever, at least from a marketing perspective. All right, so that's our first look at Moana. How exciting. She's finally arrived. So I'm curious to hear your thoughts on the character, her supporting cast, and also what do you think of the way the picture is just coming together in general. Thank you so much for tuning in, and you can check out some other episodes, more coverage from D23 right now.